the most underrated Hall of Famer. Dickie Moore won the scoring championship with a broken arm. They put a cast on it, and he kept playing. What more do you have to say about this guy?
Dickie Moore grew up in blue-collar Montreal with a reputation for toughness.
Dickie Moore suffered one or two broken legs as a kid. He nearly had one of his lips bitten off by a dog. But Dickie was not going to take no for an answer. He was going to play hockey.
His scoring ability, combined with that perseverance and will, solidified Moore as a cornerstone of the Montreal Canadiens dynasty of the 1950s.
Aggravating little guy. We got into a lot of tussles many nights.
Totally fearless, cockiness, good cockiness.
We're both the same personalities. We wanted to win.
Moore was a catalyst for six Montreal championships, including five straight Stanley Cups from 1956 to 1960. He had his greatest success under coach Toe Blake, who put the gritty winger on a line with brothers Maurice and Henri Richard. During the 1957-58 season, Moore and Henri Richard were battling the Rangers' Andy Bathgate for the league scoring title when Moore sustained an injury.
Broke my wrist. Thought my chances were all over. We had a little meeting. Toe Blake called a meeting on the train coming back from Chicago. I said, I think you should take me off the line because it's not fair for Henry, for me to handicap him from winning the scoring championship. So Toe said, well, let's ask the two brothers. They said, no way, you're staying with us.
With a cast on his wrist, Moore won the scoring title and repeated the feat the following year when he set an NHL single-season record with 96 points. He collected 35 or more goals three times with Montreal, but his numbers began to decline, leading to a meeting with general manager Frank Selke after the 1962-63 season.
I went up to see him, and he sat me down, and he says, we're thinking of trading you. I said, Mr. Selke, are you blaming me for losing last year? I don't think it's fair what you're telling me, but no, I will not accept the trade. I want to thank you for everything. I put out my hand, I thanked him, and then I said, I quit, and I walked out.
Moore sat out a season before returning with the Toronto Maple Leafs in 1964-65, and later the St. Louis Blues during their inaugural season in 1967-68.
Number 12, Moore was the marksman.
Moore led the Blues in scoring during a playoff run that would end in the final versus Montreal. In 2005, Dickie Moore and Yvon Cornoyer were honored by Montreal when the number 12 was lifted to the rafters.
I told Dickie when they gave me number 12, that for me that was a challenge to keep that number proud.
Dickie was a hugely important part of the Canadiens dynasties, and for him, the Montreal Canadiens were everything in his life.
I'm still proud, I'll be honest with you, of the five consecutive Stanley Cups. The power of winning and wanting to win, where could you get that? What organization can prove that? Not too many. In fact, none.